The law of transmutation refers to changing a particular energy into another form or type of energy. It says that energy can be transformed and is constantly changing. Change is constant and always occurring, and transmutation is a process that will govern these changes that occur in the universe. It prevents stillness and decay, and allows the progression and improvement of almost everything in the universe. The law of transmutation can also be applied to metaphysical or ethereal energy. Creative and mental energy in humans can also be transmuted to actions and changes. This energy can be transformed into different forms and actions, and is almost infinite and boundless. This energy is considered to be the most powerful type of energy, as it can be used to shape reality, and has permitted people to achieve their goals and dominate the entire world. However, without effort, thoughts, motivations, as well as focus, this energy cannot be utilized to its utmost potential. The law of transmutation occurs almost everywhere, and perpetually governs the universe. It allows the changes in the universe to continue to happen, and prevent stagnation. This allows progression and continued succession. Energy in the universe is being transformed constantly, and will continue to change. Nothing will stay in its original form, and would be constantly undergoing the process of transmutation. Energy from the environment continuously flows and undergoes transmutation. Even people undergo this transmutation. Nothing and no one is capable of escaping its grasps. Instead, one should utilize it to their fullest ability and use it to change their direction and enhance their situation. Humans are special beings with the consciousness that allows them to utilize, see, and observe the law of transmutation. People are the only beings in existence with consciousness. In a sense, people are the universe, made conscious and capable of seeing its path and shaping everything in it. Humans can utilize the law of transmutation to their own desires. They can utilize it by directing the changes in the energy to their own benefits. With it, they can utilize the energy and resources already present in the universe, and carve its shape and form whatever they want. This has permitted them to move mountains, shape rivers, and do many more things that other beings could not even comprehend. Humans are very special and powerful because of this. People also hold within themselves the capability to utilize creative and mental energies. These energies are special in such a manner that they can be used to manipulate almost everything and shape it into any form. Humans have the ability to use these energies to create an almost infinite and boundless path. They can make anything happen if they utilize these energies. These have been shown throughout all of the histories. Humans have been able to defy all logic and shape the world using their ingenuity. They can defy almost anything and utilize the law of transmutation to whatever they want. With enough focus and stubbornness, humans are able to utilize these energies and convert them into almost anything to their want as long as they are creative enough. However, one should not forget the power of cooperation. Humans are strong on their own and can realize their dreams in their lonesome. One should always remember that people can use synergy to create better results and transcend all. The law of transmutation benefits all and can be further extended to greater efficiency if people work together toward a common goal. Only then, at that point, humans can become the masters of their fate and the universe. Humans should also know how and when to start. They should always consider starting small at the beginning and slowly work it out. You can become bigger once you start out small. And usually, it is those small instances that create echoes that, in the end, would have the biggest results. So remember to begin small and not worry about it, as the beginnings often are the biggest challenges and would result in the greatest gains. The law of transmutation does not simply mean one is to one, as a one would sometimes result into a two. A small thing causing big effects is a usual occurrence here. Having companions means multiple minds that may interact and further boost knowledge and creativity. This will lead to greater energy and greater transmuting powers. One must not be worried about relationships, as it is needed to progress and enhance the individualistic aspects of oneself. Clashes of ideas and thought may happen, but it too is beneficial for everyone. This can provide outlets for discussions and would further allow the gaining of insights. Eventually, resolutions can be made that will further straighten the direction and allow progress to go much faster and in a better manner. Not all fights are bad, as some are necessary for change that will be crucial to changing the world. The law of transmutation talks about the need for focus and end goals to utilize the power within the people. Creative and mental energy is an infinite well of energy that people can harness and enjoy. However, one cannot utilize it to their utmost potential if they do not have the willpower and motivation. It would be just like gasoline that does not have a lighter. It would not burn if the lighter does not create heat and fire that will result in a chain reaction that would allow the release of massive energy and heat. In a similar case, people need a spark that will cause a series of reactions that will start the utilization of the said energy. With this, the energy inside people will burn and continue to burn until they succeed. More importantly, the universe is ever-changing, and that is because of the law of transmutation. The law of transmutation permits the change of energy, and it is constantly in effect. One should not just accept their fate and submit. They should always be willing to change their situation and utilize the creative energy present within them and not settle. They should not submit to defeatism and should struggle and fight for their dreams. This law is a powerful law that will allow everyone to shape the world. Settling should not be an option, and the people should be focused and motivated to create a better world and situation for themselves and for all. They should not stagnate and decay, as it would be counterproductive and the opposite of what this law wants. The law of transmutation is a law of change, and what was before is not guaranteed to last forever. People should always move and make use of their energy to continue onward and push for a better future. They can even collaborate to create a more holistic change and a better world for many. The law of transmutation is a law that ensures progress for all and gives the ability for everyone to induce changes in the world. So humans should always try to use it and not just lie down and be sad about their predicaments. They can always change. Change is always possible. Convert the energy within you and manifest it in a physical manner. Fundamentals of the Law of Transmutation. The universe is governed by multiple laws and rules that maintain order and prevent chaos. One of these laws is the Law of Transmutation. Transmutation means transformation. The law of transmutation refers to the transformation of a particular state or form into another form or state, which can be either for good or bad. Usually, it is the energy that is transformed. This is very much evident in the daily lives of people. The sun gives light energy that humans can harness into electricity. Electricity in the outlets can be made into light. Our bodies can move and give off energy. Humans do not accept the surroundings as it is and are capable of shaping it. They can move mountains, create rivers, bring down forests, and create cities with this energy. Humans are limitless beings that can bring forth just about every innovation and building with these energies. These types of energies are the most powerful ones, as they can be transmuted to just about anything. One must remember that to utilize this powerful energy which is present within oneself, one should put in the effort and have the vision. Without effort of becoming the catalyst to transmute the energy, it would just be useless and all for naught. Thoughts and effort must be needed to utilize this full power of this energy. Motivation is very much critical for one's own process of transmuting the creative and mental energy. Without any of these, the potent creative and mental energy that people contain would just be rendered into a stagnant form. However, not everyone can focus and use this energy. One should have an end goal in mind and must not be willing to settle for what they get as it is. There must be a will to change their conditions. This is another important realization in the law of transmutation, especially with regards to the energy of humans and their capabilities. As people, they always have the power to bring forth change and create a better situation for the world and for themselves. They should never be satisfied with the way things are and for the way things are occurring. One could always transmute and transform the energy and use it as an agent to improve the current conditions and bring about a great change. Never settle for less. Humans are the conscious part of the universe and are the only beings capable of shaping, creating, and utilizing these energies to their benefit. One must not let this ability go to waste. Lastly, transmutation is present everywhere. One must be knowledgeable and smart enough to utilize it and use their thoughts to transmute and use this energy and resources within oneself and in the environment to create a more optimal reality. Small steps, big energy. The law of transmutation simply states that energy can manifest itself in physical form. One's thoughts, their mental energy, can be used to make things happen in their will. And whether one's mental energy is positive or negative, the energy can also manifest itself physically and will create positive or negative physical effects, depending on the type of energy. This law of mental energy, transforming from one form to another, is one of the fundamental laws that the universe is acting on. It is one of the universal laws that are being exhibited in physics, or in the interaction of matter with one another. One of the most basic laws in classical physics is the law of conservation of matter. It states that matter can neither be created nor destroyed. Matter can only change physically through physical change and chemically through chemical change. Physical change is the change in which the initial object is still similar to outcome object. Take paper as an example. When one cuts paper, the paper matter is not destroyed. It is only changed from one physical form to another smaller physical form. The paper is still paper, just smaller. Chemical change, on the other hand, is the change in which the initial object is not similar to the outcome object. When one burns paper, the paper matter is not destroyed. Instead, it is only changed to ash matter. This is called a chemical change, set by the reaction of the paper with its contact with the fire. Another law in physics is the first law of thermodynamics. It is the law of conservation of energy. This law states that energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can only change from one form to another. It means that the total amount of energy in the universe is constant and will never change, and instead it only changes form. One such example is the simple kinetic and potential energy. These two energies transform themselves interchangeably with each other, depending on how an object moves. When an object falls, its potential energy is transferred into kinetic energy. This kinetic energy becomes higher the further an object falls, and the bigger its energy, the more impact it can create. When the object halts its fall, the kinetic energy of the object is transferred or transformed back into potential energy. However, these laws are shattered by a brilliant mind, that of Albert Einstein. These laws were used in an assumption that matter and energy cannot be created or destroyed. But Einstein proved them wrong. Using his very famous formula, E equals mc squared, he reasoned that one can create energy using matter, and one can create matter using energy. And it was brilliantly correct. Alongside his other works, such as the theory of relativity, Einstein was held as one of the greatest scientists to have ever lived, and has left a profound impact to the lives of almost all humans and humans of future generations. His work has led to the creation of nuclear energy. So how does the equation E equals mc squared find a loophole in the laws of conservation of matter and energy? In the famous equation, the variable E means energy, M means matter, and C is the constant speed of light. Einstein states that the amount of energy created from a single mass is equivalent to the mass being multiplied by the speed of light squared. It means that the amount of energy being stored in a single matter is extremely huge. In fact, the amount of energy stored in the matter of a single dime can power entire cities for years or even decades. However, current human technology is unable to transform such simple objects into pure energy and does not have the capacity to store them efficiently. As of the moment, there are several applications for the harnessing of energy, although they are still inefficient. To give one an idea about the amount of energy that can be stored in one matter, one can look upon the destructive effects of nuclear bombs. The amount of atom of nuclear material in a nuclear warhead only amounts to the number of atoms in a single dollar bill. However, this number of atoms is enough to obliterate entire cities. That is the amount of energy that is stored in matter. Each atom holds a very huge amount of energy. So how does Einstein's genius relate to one's own self? One can apply the equation E equals mc squared to oneself. Just a small amount of attitude can translate into a huge amount of energy, and this energy can be transformed into something good or positive. His equation can teach one that even a very small object or event can cascade into something much more beautiful, more productive, or more eventful result. Even something so simple such as a smile can carry one's attitude throughout the day. Sometimes the smallest things carry the biggest impacts, just as how the biggest trees begin their life from the smallest seeds. A small positive change in one's attitude can create a huge positive mental energy, and this positive mental energy in turn can be created into a huge positive physical energy. This energy can then be harnessed by the individual in order to make positive changes in his or her life. Just small, consistent steps are all it takes in order to achieve one's dreams. However, one must be careful, because the same is true for negative energy. Sometimes all it takes is one bad habit in order to destroy someone's life. Sometimes all it takes is one bad day, and everything cascades into chaos. One must be very careful of his or her attitude and mental energy, as it can leave a very huge impact on their lives. One must always be positive and harness their positive energy to the fullest, to live their lives to the fullest, and to realize their dreams to the fullest. Sometimes all it takes is one small positive attitude to transform one's life for the best. Multiplication, not addition. One of the basic premises of the law of transmutation is that one's thoughts or mental energy can be transformed into physical energy, and the amount of mental energy can be proportional to the physical energy it creates. Not just that, but the effects of the physical energy, whether it will be positive or negative, is also influenced by the mental energy itself. So the bigger and more positive one's mental energy is, the bigger and more positive the harnessed physical energy is. And this in turn results in a more profound and much more meaningful outcome. If one wills something, they will follow the necessary steps in order to achieve it. Their will or attitude will create mental energy, and the individual can use that energy by them following the necessary steps in order to achieve it. However, what if someone has multiple wants? What if someone wants a lot of things that may not be easy to achieve? They might have contradictory wants that their resulting wills just cancel each other out. What if someone wants to work, but they also want to study? They also want a better body. They also want a stronger and brighter mind. They also want to become more stable financially. They also want to build a good relationship with their friends and partners, etc. All of these cannot just be willed to existence. Each and every one of them might cancel one's will into doing the other, since each of them requires time and energy. Each of them needs their physical energy, and one's mental energy may not be enough to fuel them all at the same time. However, one can simply change their mindset of not adding or subtracting their different mental energies. They can simply multiply their different mental energies, born from their different wants, to create an even bigger mental energy. This bigger energy can then be transmuted into physical energy, which could be used in order to accomplish a person's wants and dreams. Addition is the process in which two numbers or entities are added to each other. It is simply a linear way of increasing and may not be able to produce the biggest results from small numbers. On the other hand, multiplication is the process in which a number or entity is added to itself multiple times, equivalent to the other number or entity. For example, in addition, 5 plus 5 equals 10. But in multiplication, 5 times 5 equals 25. They have the same number, but multiplication yields a bigger result. Another example is 100 plus 100. In addition, it is simply 200. But in multiplication, 100 times 100 is 10,000. It is very huge compared to the initial number and the result of the addition. Just a simple change from the addition of one's mental energy into multiplication of one's energy can produce a much bigger and much better results. All it took was a simple change in mindset, and it produced a much higher result. And this mindset is what sets a lot of billionaires apart from the rest. They have a winner's mentality. They have a very strong and positive attitude, energy, and will that manifested itself into something really big. They have a lot of things that they want to be done, and their focus never faded. Their mental energy was multiplied, and this huge mental energy manifested in their success. Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Steve Jobs, etc., all of them are dreamers and innovators that worked hard to turn their dreams into reality. One interesting example of this mentality would be Steve Jobs. He didn't really start good with his life. In fact, he had it pretty rough. He was raised by his adoptive parents and didn't even know about his biological mother and father until he was 30 years old. Also, he didn't excel much in the early years of elementary. However, later in elementary, when he had shown promise, he was accelerated into middle school, but was bullied there. Jobs hated middle school so much that he just wanted to drop out. In college, Jobs immediately dropped out during the first semester. Jobs had a pretty rough start in his life, but he still persuaded his love for technology. Later on, he partnered with Steve Wozniak, an American engineer, to build the Apple I computer, and from there, his success kept on coming. The later iterations of the Apple computer started to sell more, and the day Jobs publicly traded Apple, his company was valued at $1.2 billion. A guy who didn't know his real parents and was a college dropout now owns a company worth more than $1 billion. And he later on led several projects that have changed the world forever. He revolutionized animations through Pixar, the way people listened to music through the iPod, the way people talked through the iPhone, and the way people did tasks with the iPads. A college dropout, a foster child, a guy who didn't excel in academics, has changed the world forever through his sheer will and determination. His will to become successful was huge, and in turn, his mental energy, his creativity, was also huge. He wanted a lot of things, and they powered his drive for greatness. One's thoughts and wills are mental energy that one can harness to achieve something. Wanting to have a decent job will create a mental energy. Wanting to be in a good relationship creates mental energy. Wanting good physical and mental well-being create mental energy. Wanting a house and a car will create mental energy. and one must be wise and use these mental energies to their fullest. One must multiply the mental energy from these things that he or she wants in order to create a bigger mental energy. And if one spends time and effort into something, that mental energy will manifest itself. One will be successful in achieving what they really want. If one wants a lot of things done, if one wants something huge done, a simple change in mindset can really mean a huge difference. It has to be multiplication and not addition. Multiple minds, greater heights. Wanting to achieve or accomplish something empowers one to exert time and effort in order to achieve it. And this will to exert time and effort is the manifestation of his or her mental energy that pushes the individual to pursue what they want. However, for as long as humanity has existed, a lot of great things were born through the collaboration of different amazing minds. Different people, with each one having great mental energy and creativity, join forces and transform their mental energy into something great that would not be achieved by a single human alone. Humans are very social beings. People depend on each other for food, jobs, opportunities, security, love, etc. This connection with one another has been embedded in the very fabric of human society. Humans have evolved to rely on one another, just like how organs in one's body have evolved to rely on one another. In a human's body, different organs rely on the lungs to inhale oxygen and to exhale carbon dioxide. The different organs rely on the mouth to eat and the stomach to digest the food. The different organs rely on the heart to pump blood throughout the body. The different organs rely on the brain to give instructions for survival, etc. Each and every organ relies on one another for something they cannot do, and the same is true for human society. Humans have relied on farmers to create food, on the military and police for security, on the government for leadership, on the workers for the economy, on teachers and professors to enlighten the future generation, etc. Humans also need one another for emotional support, to look out for each other, and to take care of each other. And relying on one another is, without exaggeration, a very strong evolutionary advantage humans have. Greatness can be achieved through talent, hard work, a little bit of luck, and determination. But what if there are multiple people that are as hard-working and as talented as one another, working on a single project? All of their mental energies are harnessed in order to achieve something that one human being can simply not do alone. Their collective mental energy has propelled humans to heights never been witnessed before. One good example is the birth of aviation. The luxury of modern aviation humans has enjoyed for the past decades is not the product of one human being. Humans can now enjoy traveling across the world in only a matter of hours, safely and efficiently. But modern aviation was not birthed from a single person alone. It is the product of multiple generations of constant innovations from different people, of different backgrounds. It is the product of the hard work, talent, and determination of thousands, if not millions, of people throughout history. At its very infancy, the first working plane was invented by the Wright brothers. It was then improved upon by thousands of very talented and very hard-working engineers during World War I and World War II. After that, there have been countless of iterations in order to increase the efficiency and safety of these planes, to the point that statistically, it is safer to ride a plane than to travel on road. Another miracle birthed from the innovation of a lot of people is the advancement of medicine. Millions of doctors and scientists throughout history have worked collectively in order to improve the medical knowledge of humanity. Modern medicine is the product of millions of very bright and determined minds in order to achieve something spectacular for humanity. In the past, a simple wound could have led to death, as severe infections were very common back then. Today, it is nothing more than a simple inconvenience due to the rise of modern antibiotics. Back in the day, one would lose their life to a simple diarrhea. But now, there are a lot of measures in order to cure someone from diarrhea. And the advancements in the field of medicine have helped humans live longer and better. And in just 200 years, the average lifespan of humans increased by almost triple. From 29 years old of average lifespan during the 1800s, to 35 years old during the 1900s, and 70 years today. Another example of the different mind energies working together to achieve something wonderful is landing of humans on the moon. Who would have thought that humans could reach the moon? And it was done just 60 years after the first plane took off. It took just one generation to go from primal flight into reaching the moon. Humans have an insane potential of doing incredible things when they work together. Not a single human could have reached the moon alone. The effort of going to the moon took the effort and talents of millions of engineers, scientists, architects, pilots, etc. around the world. Millions of humans have pooled their mental energy and helped propel the rocket into the moon. It is through the effort of countless of people that have sacrificed a part of their lives in order to make their dream of humans of reaching the moon possible. Humans by themselves can achieve a lot of things. They can achieve feats that are unthinkable even for themselves, if they really dedicate time and effort in achieving their dreams. As long as people transform their mental energy and creativity into something productive, they can achieve their dreams and change the lives of other people around them. They can achieve their dreams of being rich, of being comfortable with life, of learning and discovering new things. However, there are dreams so big that it needs the mental energy of a lot of people. There are visions that are so huge that one person can simply not do it alone. Dreams such as reaching the moon, colonizing other planets, making the average lifespan of the world above 100, achieving universal world peace, etc., require mental energies of millions to come together. All of these are dreams that may not be achieved by a single person alone. But as a species, humans can pool their resources together, their collective intelligence, in order to achieve something better and greater. The more the number of people who contribute their mental energy into something, the better the results can be. The law of transmutation governs the changes of energy and form that is present in our reality. It allows the energy and the world to continue in its progress and not just be in a particular state and stale. This law also dictates that change is constant and would continuously occur in the world. Nothing stays the same. Nothing would be the same as it was in the beginning, and its current state might not be its final state. Transmutation would ensure transformation of everything, whether it is voluntary or not. The reality that was before cannot be maintained as is, and change would always be imminent. Change is the only thing permanent in this reality and universe. Nothing is above this law. For humans, creative and mental energy is their most powerful gift. It can be utilized and transformed into countless forms, and has allowed the shaping of reality as well as the world to what the people want or need. Humans can utilize this energy to become the most dominant creature in the world and transform the environment to what it wants. Mountains can be moved, forests could be leveled, and rivers could be shaped. Nothing can limit this energy that humans possess. However, if a person does not have the motivation and focus, this energy would not bear good fruits and could only be utilized in a limited manner. This means that for people to reach their potential, they should have an end goal and maintain focus at all times. To utilize the energy and transmute them into a more fruitful one, small steps could be made first. These small steps often would lead into big results, more than what anyone could dream of. Starting out small is not a shame, as everything that became big would start out small. Small things could also bring forth large stuff. So that should be kept in the mind. In the world of physics, E equals mc squared is a famous equation that led to atomic energy. This shows that a small amount of matter can release a huge amount of energy. Comparing it to one's daily life, this means that small actions could cause a chain reaction that could bring forth huge and powerful change, especially the ones that are directed toward the person's life. One should also not forget that humans are capable of working together and amounting to much more. Humans are capable of linking their energies and transmuting it into a larger form of energy. This means that people who work together are much more capable than what two people working separately could ever do. Humans are social beings that can utilize synergy to produce more results. Synergy refers to the product of a group that works together, having more potential and value than the work of the same number of individuals added together. This would imply that together, humans can transmute in a larger capacity, thus allowing more change and transformation to occur if they work hand in hand. The law of transmutation has allowed people to soar toward greater heights, whether as individuals or groups. People in groups have been able to do more and have shown to be much more capable. Using synergy and the power of creative and mental energy, humans can do just about anything. As long as they put the effort, focus, and thoughts, they can transform this energy into physical manifestations and shape the world on their own.